Look at that. We're back. Instantaneously back in the game. I can't believe modern technology. Look at that. All right. God bless the Switch and not wanting to play anything else on it for a while, so we don't have to worry about it. If we finish early today, we'll probably put on a mix of stuff, a little Fall Guys and a little something else. Photo of Daniel.
Why do you think Jethro here survived?
His name is Daniel. He's been through a lot. You don't have to, misname him.
Why?
Jethro was his cousin.
I mean, doesn't he look like the kind of guy who'd die first in a horror movie?
He did have his arm bit off by an alligator.
He married into the Clarkson family. He didn't possess Clarkson blood, so he had nothing to do with Helena Doman's plan.
The blood purge thing?
That's the one.
But if that was all there was to it, then yet a ton of the Clarkson gang members died, along with Sheriff Woods. Doesn't add up.
She did whatever it took to achieve her goals. She'd kill if the plan required it.
In fact, I believe she did.
But killing people outside of the Clarkson family was never a priority. Her ultimate goal was to cut off the Clarkson bloodline. Maybe he was always meant to be an assistant to the goddess of fertility.
I mean, that could not have been a merit-based hire. Unless Melvin was just pretending to be stupid, in which case he's one of the greatest actors of all time. There is no way she took... She took multiple offers and Melvin was the best.
What, like a servant?
He was the kind of person who was most in his element when he had someone to serve.
Like a waiter.
Even afterwards, he let Patricia take over the estate, while he became her assistant. As soon as he settled into his role, the townspeople started to respect him. Now they practically revere him, and he's even earned himself a nickname. One-armed Danny.
A name of reverence.
So you think his life played out exactly the way Professor R
planned it to go? Just a physical characteristic plus his name.
Talk about tragic.
All right, what about a photo of Patricia?
I was so positive. But she isn't here. There is something about this room, though.
Oh, you think? Maybe the disfigured mannequin with a JPEG of Cameron Diaz's face on it?
Agent Jones, what do you think?
Me? I'm not as smart as you. Why are you even asking me?
Are you hiding something?
What? He's got a slice of pizza in his back pocket.
Of course not. Knock it off. Me? Hiding something? That's a good one.
Break in case of emergency.
Come on. I got nothing to hide.
Or does he?
I thought I would find answers in this room. I thought that Patricia would be here. But I was wrong. This room is only filled with photos of people related to the case and the handiwork of a madman.
I mean, I'm loving the deer with the Professor R hair and the bear with the PJ Clarkson eye patch.
Feels like I'm wandering through a heavy mist.
And don't it feel good?
Why is Morgan showcasing those women's photos? And that bed.
Lee's-esque cloth doll.
If you loved someone from the bottom of your heart, would you ever be able to marry someone else? Or kill for them?
Whoa, what are we talking about?
It's a pretty straightforward question.
I've never heard of any kind of motive like that in any other murder case.
Really? A jilted lover has never been the motive for a murder before? Have you ever investigated a murder before?
I just keep feeling like we're being fed a story that he made up in his mind.
True. Honestly, without having experienced what that's like,
He's never been in love.
But I'd never try and force love to happen if it didn't seem like it was meant to be. There are 3.5 billion women on this planet.
But once you take away the ones that are over 30 or the ones that have been with multiple partners in advance of meeting me, that actually makes the dating pool quite small.
There's got to be more than one specific person who anyone can fall deeply in love with, right?
But what if we were talking about pizza?
Oh, now we're talking.
You just discovered the perfect ultimate pizza.
Oh, baby.
But you aren't allowed to take even a single bite.
That's cruel.
Unless you kill someone for the cook.
Have you ever loved someone with all your heart?
Because that's how I feel about pizza.
What kind of person do you take me for?
That's my line.
Answer the question, Simon. Answer the question, Simon!
The one who took her in after the incident was Daniel Clarkson, the next in line to succeed the Clarkson family. He's the one that ended up raising her from that point onwards.
Could he raise her above his head?
Isn't fate strange? In the end, two people who were completely unrelated by blood ended up inheriting that house.
Yeah. You're right. But sometimes I wonder, what is family anyway?
It's a tough one.
Go back far enough, we're all strangers to one another.
No, it's like the exact opposite. I think if you go back far enough, we're all family, Simon.
We're talking countless generations, marriages, and birth, you know.
Humans love to deify the rules they create. It's almost like that's been an unwritten law from the very start.
Didn't know you were an anthropologist. Also, I have no idea what you're talking about at all, for the record. We've got to turn down the volume on those floors.
Why did Lise have to die first?
Just finish the shading on your upper lip. Hate that. Just a couple of rolled up towels and a pair of short shorts.
Ooh. Green tree.
You got gloves on.
What is this?
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Oh, okay. Back to the drawing board then.
Such a bizarre picture. But upon closer look, I can see some strange sort of pattern to it all. Was Morgan trying to recreate something with all this?
I think the rat just ate some of his milk and died.
So, there must be a reason for all of these weird and hideous things.
Can you imagine going to your friend's house, they opened up their bedroom and it looked like this? I just can't.
I've seen the bedrooms of countless violent criminals, but this one is on a completely different level. It's beyond insane.
I gotta admit though, that thing is pretty sick. Everything else in this room is terrifying, but the bear head with a cigar and an eye patch is extremely baller. This would fit in like a Al's den from Married with Children or a frat house. This would be beautiful.
What's that?
A hunting trophy. A brown bear with a dragonfly eye patch.
Why is it smoking a cigar?
Well, it's not smoking, Simon. It's dead.
It's probably supposed to represent Philip J. Clarkson's body.
And the elk is?
Yeah, it looks like when you do the Twitch emote modification and you put sunglasses on something that it doesn't fit on. It's actually like one-to-one. Hold on. If you could do modify a single emote, lion baby. Oh, they won't let me do sunglasses on it because it's already like a tier 2 solution or something. I don't know how this works. As a tier 3 sub, I can't put it on. You guys can. There you go. thank you.
Helena Doman.
So that's why it's got such good taste in fashion. And this one is Galena Clarkson?
Why did he want to line up corpses that were killed in different places, all together in a single room?
Because of the red seeds? In his bedroom? Red rope! Red rope! Red rope!
When Helena Doman returned home, someone must have let her inside.
You think that was her brother-in-law, Daniel?
I don't know.
Well, alligators did chomp his arm off. He probably had it in for old man PJ, too. But, you know, I don't think he had anything to do with this.
It's mighty fine police work, Simon.
Why not?
You're making it out to be more complicated than it really is. That's always the problem with people like you. Too smart for your own good.
I miss the days when cops didn't use their brain. You just planted a gun on the first person you found lying down and called it a day.
Just get to the point.
Professor R marched straight through the front door to the mansion. She arrived right at her destination using the quickest route possible, without having to undergo a single security check.
She didn't even get through a recapture.
I know.
Because she's family. It doesn't matter if PJ disowned her. A father would never abandon his child, no matter how much they fail to fulfill his expectations.
This guy hasn't seen Infinity War.
That's what being a parent is all about. Don't look at me like that. I know. I don't have a son myself.
Really? Oh, you don't have kids, Simon. I couldn't tell.
But I have a father. He's still back in my hometown, managing the printing plant my grandfather started. He'll be turning 80 soon.
Simon, how old are you? He'll be turning 80 soon? I honestly thought Simon was 32 years old.
He wanted me to take over the place, but as you can see, I'm out here. But I know how this whole thing works.
He looks good for his age if he's 40. I mean, it's all the pizza.
Even though I haven't seen him in forever, the minute I go home, he'll welcome me with warm, open arms.
All right, didn't really ask about that, but that's okay.
You sure it's okay to press that?
Won't know until we try.
Random.
Hey, it's Woodstock.
What are you talking about?
Look, a peace sign.
Oh, I see.
Love and peace, man.
Remember that?
Even I can figure out what this is from. It's Jimi Hendrix, Janis Joplin, Grateful Dead, and Led Zeppelin. But I shouldn't have to explain it to a music nut like you, right?
Simon definitely thinks rap isn't music. There is no doubt in my mind. This is one of those guys who's like, I like all kinds of music except rap.
That isn't a peace mark. It's upside down. You don't need to be a music nut to see that.
Who says that's the top part? If you're looking from Lisa's head, this is the top part, making it a big, fat peace mark.
No, this is the ground.
Where's your proof?
The red seeds. Seeds go in the ground, right?
Or in your mouth.
That makes this wall the bottom. Lisa's head is clearly at the top. Period. Awesome. Agent Jones. Led Zeppelin never played at Woodstock.
Dummy. You're thinking of Joe Cocker.
He's representing a human with a hunting trophy made from an animal. I feel like I'm looking at a piece of modern art done in really bad taste.
Yeah, more like modern fart. I gotta
know. Anagram. The first victim of the Greenvale case. Her body was found hanging from a tree, like a goddess being worshipped in a sanctuary.
I'll use my hands.
Meanwhile, Lise Clarkson was found on the bank of a river in an area that had been fashioned into an altar. The person who gruesomely ended the life of that young woman must be brought to justice.
I completely agree. They both still had their whole lives ahead of them.
I'm glad we're both on the same page that murder deserves to be punished.
The Lucare case and the Greenvale case. According to my investigation, the one key that links both cases is Francis Zack Morgan. But if we look at the cases from his point of view...
The Jedi are evil?
We see one more connection. The Red Seeds are also present in both cases. I believed that he was the one who brought them to both towns.
No, you fool. You don't know what we know. FK brought the Red Seeds.
But maybe... Nah, never mind.
Like, according to this lady, if you investigate two unsolved murders, you are the murderer. Although I will admit, if you were the cop on two murder investigations and then your bedroom looked like this, I probably would suspect you as well, quite frankly.
Sure seems like our friend Daniel here was just destined to suffer.
Well, that was decided as soon as we chose to play a first-person shooter.
He crossed the entire continent and married into the Clarkson family, all for the sake of the woman he loved. But then the love of his life became a drug addict and ended up murdering their very own daughter. And she too was murdered as part of her big brother's conspiracy.
Big brother conspiracy?
Finally, in order to prove that he could take responsibility for the family, he gave up his right arm to his father-in-law, who got blown to bits soon afterwards. And to add insult to injury, all the inheritance went to PJ's secret heir.
Why is this the intro to Arrested Development? I'm losing it. This is Arrested Development.
If I had to go through all that, I'm pretty sure I'd go crazy.
I don't know.
Dunk, 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 dee, dunk, dunk, dee, dunk, dee, dunk.
What do you mean?
He found someone he loves so much. He moved across the entire continent.
Why are Americans always like he moved across the continent? Like he moved from Texas to Louisiana, and they're like, it was a long voyage across the country.
It also seems that he was eventually able to make an identity for himself and Lucare as well. After I found his daughter's body, I interrogated him for a bit. When I told him we were going to do an autopsy on her body, he didn't react violently in any way. I remember him looking relieved and tired. Kind of like someone who'd just woken up from a coma.
Why? I mean, I would want the autopsy done too, I think, quite frankly.
She planned a string of murders all in order to restore the Clarksons to their former glory, right?
Yeah. According to Morgan's story. Matches up with the files, too.
But the only proof of that is the confession she privately gave to Morgan just before she died. Galena Clarkson was also murdered immediately after she confessed. Don't you think it's all a little too convenient?
That's how the Mafia works, baby.
Well, story-wise, yeah.
And the sacrifices. None of the FBI's official records contain an example of an actual human sacrifice.
It broke new ground.
Aside from the cases that Francis Zack Morgan handled, that is.
There are tons of examples of animal sacrifice, though. And remember the witch hunts back in the Middle Ages?
Meaning?
Meaning there are always exceptions to the rule. And Morgan alluded to the existence of some sort of journal, right? I think he said he read it in Professor R's lab. If we could find that, maybe this would all become easier to swallow.
Like a delicious slice of za.
The report didn't mention anything about a journal. And if it truly did exist, it surely would have been submitted as evidence. Unless he tried to cover it up on purpose. Or?
Unless the journal never existed in the first place.
Exactly.
You said exactly, but I honestly have no idea what you were talking about at all.
He was taught how to rule as a child. never confided in anyone, and married for purely political reasons. Then he prospered so much that he became powerful enough to rule an entire town on his own. Hmm. But in the end, his own child betrayed him.
No, I'm okay.
And ended his
entire
clan in a series of violent deaths. If that was your life, how would you look back on it?
I don't know. I think if they, you know, edified me as a one-eyed bear smoking a cigar, I'd think that I did a few things right.
Yeah. Beats, I wasn't born into a rich family, nor was I ever taught how to rule.
My father only owned a mid-size printing press.
And for what it's worth, I've also never knocked up a young ex-actress.
Yeah, I think that goes without saying, Simon.
But I guess the one thing we can say is that any good life needs balance. Get too hung up on one thing, and you lose sight of everything else. And if you betray someone, you'll get betrayed too.
An eye for an eye, huh?
Someone thinks they can step all over people and then live out the rest of their life in peace. They're fooling themselves. We always get to see how those people end up in our line of work. In the end, they die horrible deaths. That is why pizza is the only thing I trust.
You knew it was coming.
Pizza never betrays you.
Pizza definitely betrays you. Not just in, you know, immediate heartburn, but, you know, later on in life, catastrophic health effects. I'm not saying I don't like it, but...
This case took place in Lucare.
Yeah, plus Michael Jordan's flu game.
Oppressive authority, cross purposes, madness. But Katrina took the truth along with many innocent lives and buried it all at the bottom of the swamp.
I love that the narrative here is also tied into Hurricane Katrina. It just is like the perfect added air of drama.
But there's one truth that can never be washed away. This all started with the death of a young girl.
Who cried a river and drowned the whole world.
Galena Clarkson went to California to become an actress.
Can you lower your voice, please?
But things never took off for her, so she eventually returned home. Then she murdered her own daughter and ended up like this. Where did she go wrong?
She did manage to appear in a few movies, right?
Mostly Uwe Boll films.
Not as any characters with actual names. And never with much clothes on.
So that's the only value they saw in her, huh? Sorry, that was insensitive.
It's an everyday occurrence in that world. She was also bullied a lot.
Bullied? How?
They'd cut up her costumes, her scripts, and even her own clothes.
So you're telling me they would hire her for an acting role, and then when she got there, they would cut up her script in front of her. Yo, maybe you're right. You think that's the origin of the snarfs? Snip, snip, I want to cut it off.
Everywhere she went. Then after 3 years of that, her stylist chopped off a chunk of her hair. By accident.
Were her arms perhaps bound by chains to a large wooden door when she did it?
Are you kidding me?
Or do you think the stylist is the one that goes, "Voo!"
I did a little investigating on this. In the end, a self-titled Big Cheese producer tricked her. She almost ended up going into porn.
Not hard to imagine what would have happened after that.
I bet it's not hard for you to imagine, Simon. You pervert.
One witness said that after returning to Lucare, she refused to use scissors to cut anything.
I want to cut it off. You like that,
Why
Kate?
Why did she believe what Professor R told her? The whole blood purge story. There's no way anyone in their right mind would ever believe that.
You didn't see what we saw.
You got a point.
No matter how badly all the bullying must have broken her heart. I just find it too hard to believe.
I'm still coming to terms with the fact that this is like, we're coming to the end of the game. They literally had three enemies in the whole game and one boss. It's like the God of War model. You got Snip, Snip, Snarf. You got Man Who Shakes Out locks that are actually crabs. And then you've got Vu. Oh, you're right. There were two bosses. There was Fetus Boss, and then also Fire Boss, right? A boss that shot a fireball at us. Oh, sorry. I forgot about the alligators. My mistake.
Don't you?
Yeah. But you shouldn't think too hard about it.
In our line of work.
Why not?
Human beings don't make sense. We always do things that can't be explained with common logic. Especially when it concerns our parents, children, and siblings.
Mm-mm. That doesn't satisfy me. No matter how irrational an action may be, I want to know exactly why that person made such an irrational decision. Otherwise, what hope do we have?
Why does she only have one glove on me?
You're never going to be in a situation where everything makes perfect sense. Just stop sticking your nose so deeply into everything.
She's a detective, dude. She's a detective.
That's my advice, as an old guy who's lived twice as long.
What? As an old guy who's lived twice as long as you? I thought they were the same age. I'm trying to run the math, and I'm like, how old is Simon? His dad is 80. He's twice as old as this lady is. He's got to be like 50. He's got to be 50. This is the only thing that makes... He looks really good for 50, if he's 50. He's got no wrinkles whatsoever. Look at that hairline, too. Considering his whole diet is pizza, plus he's wearing a tan suit. That's how you know he's got the drip.
You and I are nothing alike. You decided to give up on your life and spend the rest of your time on Earth sitting around and playing Sudoku.
Oh, got him. That's really cast a pall on the room.
Everyone thinks that the principal thing to the tree is the fruit. But in point of fact, the principal thing to it is the seed. Now I know why Lise Clarkson was murdered first. Lise's death was Professor R having second thoughts. According to Morgan, her plan was to perform parricide and filicide.
I get it. You went to college.
Then commit suicide. Those were the three deaths necessary to complete the ritual, remember? Which means she technically could have killed Patricia first. That would have been the best way to delay any interference from the Clarksons themselves. The reason she didn't kill Patricia first is because Lena was actually following a different plan inside her own mind. Or perhaps she merely changed her plan as she followed through with it. At some point, new emotions started to take root within her. She had second thoughts about something. And in order to shake those off, she used Galena to kill Lise first.
It's all very complicated.
In order to cut off any possible escape, but that only made her plan move ahead quicker than she could have ever imagined, which forced her to rush right up to the end with those misgivings always in the back of her mind.
Huh? Wait, hold on.
He looks so confused.
Yeah, you lost me. What are you talking about?
Simon, the everyman.
In other words, at some point, Helena Doman decided that she wanted to make Patricia the next heir. The blood purge wasn't for the goddess of fertility. It was for their daughter, Patricia.
Wait, are you saying Helena knew from the start that Sheriff Woods would die with Candy?
That's the only explanation I can think of.
Huh.
Remember, this is only assuming that everything Morgan told us was true. Until I can trust that man, this is all nothing more than conjecture.
Well, get used to conjecture.
Considering how insane this all is, it sounds perfectly believable to me.
Oh, he's back. Isn't that right, my fairy? He is not back. No, no. Hoongin, you're done. Get out of here.
Francis Zach Morgan. Remember me?
Yes. And your your snake that does not move. Your tongue.
Understood. You know why I'm here, don't you? Surely, you must know what this means. To commemorate our reunion, allow me to give you another oracle.
He looks like he's cutting a promo in the WCW.
Once signed, will last for eternity.
Okay, that's Patricia.
But only in the presence of true love.
All right, I got no idea what that means. Maybe I'd rather not know.
Good.
And I'm coming for you, Lex Luger!
It's been a while since I felt this. You know, there's hardly anyone in this era who can see me like you can.
Everybody's too busy looking at their phones.
And they've been dropping like flies since you first came to see me. Breaks my heart.
Oh, look at the time. It's I'm dead o'clock.
We don't have much time. Do you have any questions for me?
You wanna get some lunch?
Excellent. You pass. You haven't changed, Francis Zach Morgan. But that question isn't for me to answer.
Oh,
go.
Thank you.
And see it with your own eyes. Oh, time's up. We'll have to
new song.
This during our next reunion.
Yo, it's the start of an Animal Collective song. Okay, we don't have to go all the way. Oh, it's just his ringtone. Fail to apprehend target. Target escaped with hostage. Whereabouts unknown.
Agent Jones.
What the heck? My DoorDash driver forgot the pizza.
What is this referring to?
Avery Smith kidnapped Patricia Clarkson and escaped.
Avery Smith? The vault manager? Why would he kidnap Patricia? Tell me what's going on right now.
Well...
Answer me, Jones.
I made a deal with Morgan. Back when he took me to the bathroom.
What?
Morgan said something to me. If we want to find Patricia, we need to look at Avery Smith.
Have you lost your mind?
What he said made sense. Ever since 2005, Avery's been working deep inside that cold storage warehouse. He was also arrested in the past for getting too friendly with Lise Clarkson.
This is a very strange euphemism.
And after Katrina, he apparently worked on renovating the warehouse for free. What if that allowed him to freely modify the warehouse as he pleased? That would explain why her body remained missing for 14 whole years. Then I did a little check and found out that he never went back to work after Christmas vacation ended.
So what? Why would you trust him?
I don't.
Dummy.
I just decided it was worth investigating, that's all. So, I sent two agents to Avery's house without telling anyone.
Yo, this is why he was in the bathroom for so long.
I just called in a favor from an old friend in the New Orleans branch.
We post on a lot of subreddits together.
No one gave you clearance for that. You think you can just...
But what if Morgan's telling the truth? If he is, we're both gonna look like total clowns. Clowns who went barging into a former agent's house on completely unfounded suspicions. HQ will have a field day with us. They'll string us up as the two dumbest agents to have ever graced the field.
They still might.
I just wanted to take some precautions. And besides, if he is lying, it's still no skin off our backs, right? if things work out, we'll end up solving a difficult case that's been driving everyone crazy. Imagine that! You and me, just the two of us, solving a case like this. I'll be able to jump ship on this crappy job. And you'll be able to freely investigate all things
Sandwich. It's a union gig.
Just like you've always wanted. Besides, you know that Morgan is Director Abraham's favorite. Even if we get into some sort of trouble, if Morgan testifies to Abraham's for us, we'll totally be in the clear.
I don't care. This isn't the way things are supposed to be done.
Well, I'm sorry, but I had no other choice. You were so engrossed in this, and come on, you know how I am. Besides, saving the hostage should take priority above all else. There's no time for squabbling. We need to find Avery Smith, no matter what it takes.
We did squabble, though, for, like, I don't know, maybe the past hour. Like, you really just let her do her investigation here?
But how?
Well...
Thanks to your heroic maneuvers, we just lost our suspect.
I know how to find him.
Oh! Isn't that right, my fairy?
I should be able to see the other world. The way I am now.
It's goddamn Dragon Slayer doppelganger.
Just let me go. Please.
Just let me go. Please!
Morgan?
It's okay, my fairy. I know I can convince them.
Frantic Simon or Poised Aaliyah? Or Budding Red Corpse? I mean, at this point, we gotta go with Simon.
I don't have much time left. I'm pretty sure that's why I can see the other world now. I'd lost that sense ever since the Greenvale incident, but it's back now. Please, will you just trust me? Come on, Simon. You'll trust me, won't you?
What?
No, Agent Jones. Remember the warning I gave you at the very beginning?
Don't wear red?
You can't let him take control of the conversation.
God, he's good.
Yeah, I know. I know.
I found the first one last autumn. A dead rat with a bud coming up out of its stomach, just like this one. A rat ate a red seed, died, and the bud sprouted. Honestly, it shocked me. Up until this
point, was it running around in circles?
I'd only
first?
Ever seen red seeds, saplings, and big trees. So I decided to grow one of my own.
What are you talking about?
I needed to solve the mystery of the red trees. Why do they exist? But all of my sprouts died without ever growing the tiniest bit. Forget about a big tree. I couldn't even grow a single sapling.
So you kept experimenting?
2 days after the seed enters a rat, it takes the rat's life. On the third day, a bud sprouts up, then grows to that size after 5 more. I tested this on 137 corpses.
In only a few months?
He's impressed. Blech.
But I was never able to grow a bud any larger than this size. I still remember what he told me. Apparently, there's a special trick to making these grow.
You're totally insane.
You're the one who's out, Zacky. Out of your mind.
Maybe.
That's all we got. Poised Aaliyah.
Aaliyah Davis, let me go.
Belle.
This is our case to finish.
No, you aren't an agent anymore.
But you don't know how to find him. Neither of you ever could.
Here's a hint. Look up.
Oh, I'll find him. I swear on my pride as an active agent that I won't give up until I do.
That won't get you anywhere. It's beyond you.
He's 6'8". He might even be 6'10". He's uncatchable.
Shut up. You think we can't find him, but you can. Just how stupid do you think we are? If you want us to believe you, then it's about time you showed us some proof.
I mean, I'm not trying to milk it, but the dialogue, it never gets better.
If your story is true...
This is what we gotta squeeze for all it's worth right here.